Hello everyone and welcome back to the Software Pulse, a brand new weekly segment and bulletin all about the latest software and applications. So this week we're diving into a few interesting things, although this week hasn't been hideous on the news side of stuff, hopefully it will give you a nice roundup. So guys, before we dive in, make sure to claim 2 months free of Skillshare Premium below, and you can also check out my free course all about to-do list applications and how to pick the perfect one for you, as well as getting ready on the platform to enjoy my new Notion course releasing on May 14th. So the first application which is making waves is Bear, and Bear Notes is released 1.5. Now in their latest update, they have released sidebar modifications allowing you to add a few different areas like untag, to do, and today, as well as launching the new tag icons which make your experience look awesome. Now if using Pro, there's a few other theme elements, but apart from that, it's a really nice polish to the application. Now Bear is available on iOS and Mac, so do make sure to check that one out. Now in the last week, Newton has added True Inbox, allowing you to send emails without necessarily having to go into check your sent folder all the time. Now this brand new addition is rolling out now and is really useful, especially if you're trying to send emails and start conversations with other people. Now just a disclaimer, I do work with Newton, but I just wanted to share this useful news. The next resource is CloudApp. Now I'm a big CloudApp user. I use it on Mac to capture quick modifications or even just screen shares and share it with people. Well, they've got a new UI which looks fantastic. So you can add new drops to the web interface and even share them with other people. Now, if you don't know, Taskade is a beautifully designed new application to the space. It has been making waves and the new design is something that many people are pointing me towards. I will be doing a separate review very, very soon, but the application is definitely something on the radar. Now, talking of sort of that product hunt space, Snooze Tabby is an application that you can download for Chrome, allowing you to snooze Chrome tabs, which is pretty cool. The application has got lots of upvotes and it's something that I think lots of people will find very helpful. Talking of product hunt, another application called Dimmer has released a beta experience for document creating. Now the application does look pretty neat and the way they structure their documents looks very interesting. With the likes of Coda, Notion, and a host of other applications entering the space, it's going to be a really interesting space as they take on the likes of Google Docs and Evernote in document creation. And one final bit of news to sort of get you excited is OmniFocus 3 is coming very soon. Now the application of course has been sort of being teased for a fair while now, but it now has access to beta for iOS and Mac. I'll include the link in the description so you can go away and check it out, but it's something that a lot of people are eager to get their fingers on. Anyway guys, hopefully that was a nice roundup for you. Let me know in the comments what you thought and heard in the productivity software space this week. Maybe I missed something, it'd be great to hear. But if you're brand new to this channel, make sure to hit that subscription button now. Just before we go, make sure to claim those 2 months of free Skillshare, but I'll be back again next week with another feature, so hopefully I will see you then. Anyway guys, thanks so much for stopping by, make sure to have a great week, keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.